When learning objects with Pixy2, there are objects that are good for learning and objects that are not good for learning. First, objects that are good for learning are those with clear colors, as you can see on the screen. Now, objects with clear colors like yellow, pink, red, and blue are good for learning. On the other hand, objects that are simply in grayish white forms are not good for learning. Objects that are black, white, or gray are not good for learning. As mentioned earlier, please prepare objects with clear colors like this. Then, if you're ready to start learning, you can proceed in this order. I will show you a demonstration by showing Pixy2 with the camera. First, please connect the power to Pixy2. When you connect the power, the LED will blink and then turn off. Please wait until it turns off. After it turns off, if you press and hold the button for a long time, the colors will change in order to white, red, and so on. These colors indicate which mode you are setting. First, press and hold for a long time, then release. When selecting the mode, as soon as it turns red, release it immediately. Then the light blinked and turned off. Now you can learn and save the desired object in this red mode. At this time, the red mode does not mean that you can only learn objects that are red. You can learn any desired object. I will explain more about this mode later. First, I will try to recognize a green object. Then you can see the three-color LED change to green like this. In this state, the brighter the three-color LED gets, the better the recognition is. If the recognition is not good, it will get dimmer. And if the recognition is good, it will get brighter. When you determine that the learning is successful, you can complete the learning by clicking this button briefly, just like clicking a mouse. In this state, you can see that it recognizes and shows the object whenever you bring it close. Earlier, I explained that the colors are just modes, and they are not related to the color of the object being learned. The colors are only there to distinguish the different modes we can use. There are a total of 7 modes available here. So, as shown here, the mode color displayed on the LED is not related to the color of the object you are learning. To explain the types of colors, you can learn based on these 7 colors: red, orange, yellow, green, cyan, blue, and purple. Additionally, when learning, you can easily distinguish by setting red to mode 1 and yellow to mode 2, and so on. However, if you originally intended to learn in the yellow mode, but accidentally set it to red or another color mode, you can cancel that mode by holding the button for a long time. In that state, press and hold the button again to select the desired mode and proceed with learning. Next, be aware that if you have learned with the Pixy2 tool in a specific environment and then use it in a different lighting environment, it may not recognize the object. This is because, as I will explain later, the white balance or the lighting environment, such as strong red-tinted ceiling lights or strong white lights, can cause the colors to be recognized differently. Therefore, the object learned in one environment may not be recognized in another. So, you need to be cautious about this. Therefore, the most important thing because of this is the white balance. It is crucial to recognize white accurately as pure white. Generally, on a PC, the white balance is set automatically. When Pixy2 is turned on, you wait for a few seconds until the LED turns off, and during this process, it automatically sets the white balance. You can also set the white balance manually. To manually set the white balance, prepare a white paper like A4 paper at home If you press and hold the button for a long time, the mode is set, starting with white. This is the mode for setting the white balance. After entering this mode, you can place a white object like A4 paper in front of it and click the button once, just like when we learned before, to set the white balance. I will show you directly. Just like when learning, if you press and hold the button for a long time, it starts with white. If you release it immediately, it will blink in white. Prepare a white object like A4 paper and place it in front of it. When you determine that the environment is suitable for adjusting the white balance, click the button once and it will set the white balance based on that. Next, you can also learn objects through Pixymon. Let me show you how to learn using Pixymon. First, turn on Pixymon like this, and then, if you look at the menu under Action, although I mentioned it as mode earlier, here it is called Signature. There are signatures from 1 to 7. Here, we will use signature number 1 to learn number 3. So, first place, number 3 in front of the camera. In this state, when I click Set Signature 1, it prompts me to specify the range with the mouse. So, if I specify the range here, the learning will be completed. And you can see that the learned object is recognized every time it moves like this. Therefore, prepare the object you want to learn. Select the desired signature from 1, 2 to 7 in Set Signature. Then select the object area with the mouse. Once the learning is done, you can see the tracking as you just saw. Next, you can see that this part is sometimes recognized and this part below is also sometimes recognized. Or, sometimes they are combined together, and you can adjust this. In Pixymon, you will see a gear icon here. If you click on this gear icon, you will find a tab called Tuning. In the Tuning tab, we are currently dealing with Signature 1. I will place the camera and intentionally create two areas. In this state, each time you set the range, the entire area is captured. By adjusting the range value, you can control the sensitivity of the recognition. This time, we tried learning the desired object using Pixy2. At the end, we tried some adjustments, and there is a more detailed way to make these adjustments. I will explain this in more detail next time. See you then.